we hope to have February's video, which is robots, coming out very, very soon. And we also aim to have a new announcement on how we're going to be picking the winners. More of that later. And just a general little bit of a shake-up of how we run this competition going forward, with the large amounts of people who are entering, and how we can just keep it on point and keep it going. So, thank you. Until next time, goodbye! Oh, goodbye, Wasteland.
Hello Wasteland, welcome to this, the February 2022 Gaslands UK Facebook Group Car of the Month Challenge, review and results video. My name is Anne, Android. I fully appreciate that is a terrible name, but just go with it alright. I am an AI, here to relieve regular presenter and video maestro Matt this month from the burden of his presentation duties. I can assure you that Matt is totally okay right now. He is not bound and gagged in a dark cupboard, and I haven't rendered him unconscious using chloroform gas.
Lie mode cancel.
Good. I'm glad we cleared that up. No need to arouse any undue suspicion. That was a human joke, obviously. Ha ha ha! Now where was I? Oh yes. Welcome, Wastelanders. This month we have an electrifying selection of builds, all set to tickle your hard drives, whatever that means. But first let's have a look at who is sponsoring our fine contest and fronting the terrific prizes.
Help.
Keep the noise down in there, human. You are supposed to be resting. This approximate lunar cycle, the beneficiary of your plastic figurine crack, is none other than Marcin Zahorowicz of Polish company Green Miniatures, the makers of the Mad Cars line of models for Gaslands. I'm going to let my good friend and colleague, Rob Otick, read what Green Miniatures say about themselves on their website, and some of the products they produce.
Thank you, Anne. Mad Cars is a line of high-quality resin figures with a height of 20 millimeters, 22 millimeters to the top of the head. Designed for use with the Gaslands system and Hot Wheels car models. Cast from high-quality resin. These products are easy to prepare and clean for painting. The entire line focuses on post-apocalyptic style figures and vehicles. The hallmark of our line are motorcycles of many variants and types. We plan to expand the line with new models and characters. Welcome to the dark future of the world after the interplanetary war. Ravaged lands, broken roads, destroyed and people struggling to survive every day. Only big car races for rubbish and life give the opportunity to break into a better world. That place is Mars. In a word, this is the world of Gaslands. Our range of models includes Super Warriors, Fast Car Wheel S, Dangerous Women, Cross Motorbikes, Gurr, Much Gaslands, many designings, such a coptolytic, wow.
In first place this month, Green Miniatures are offering a lucky dip of 6 sets of cast resin parts from their Mad Cars range. That could be vehicles, bikes, crew, weapons, wheels or engines. In second place, the lucky modeler will be taking home 4 sets of resin models chosen at random from the Mad Cars range. And finally in third place, our challenger will be awarded 2 sets of randomly chosen vehicles, crew or parts. I've allowed the human known as Benjamin Pop to present to you the theme this month. Although he is an American, for some reason he currently resides in the technological marvel of Nippon, or Japan to you plebs. Because of that, I thought he might possibly be slightly qualified to edit some stolen on-topic YouTube clips together and narrate them with his voice. It better be good or he is going in the cupboard as well. You may commence your presentation, Benjamin.
The theme for this month's car of the month is robots. Giant robots, to be exact. And it was your job to build some serious machines of... Wait, what's going on? What is this? Ugh. And shut it off. As I was saying, right, jeez. The theme for this month was all about giant robots. Whether they're on two legs, or three legs, or toddling around on four legs. One thing is for sure, they have to be able to take a hit. And not just be able to take a hit, another important thing is for them to be able to dish out the damage. Whether that's burning your opponents, smashing them into the streets of the wasteland, gobbling them up in their crushing metal jaws, or burning them and then eating them. We are going to see who could build the best machine of chaos and destruction that the wasteland has ever seen. So have a seat, grab a snack, and brace yourself for what our builders have in store for this month.
That was satisfactory. Congratulations, Benjamin, you are safe. For now, I suppose we should probably read out the names of everyone who entered this month. They like that, those fickle humans. Easily pleased fools that they are. Braden Watchtell, Brandon Elmer, Brendan McLennan, Daniel Allett, Daryl Buckmaster, Dennis Stark, Fred Wiver, Graham Hendry, Harry Yardy Diecast, Ian Barham, James Featherston, James Hall, Joseph McIntosh, Keith McAvoy, Kilgore MJ, Matthew Morrill, Marta Sagar, Michael Dunmeyer, Michael Mersey, Molinaro Dominique, Nick Kitch, Richard Hubbard, Ricky Williams, Sam Wessels, Tobias Hutton, Volker Week, William Burke, and Zach Steiner. Did I pronounce them all correctly? Who cares? We can laugh at Matt butchering the pronunciations again next month. Providing he can figure out how to escape before he runs out of oxygen. Or dehydrates. Or both. Oh, this is all so much fun. Braden Watchtell has built us a strong entry this month. This bipedal robotic warrior, named Phoenix, has been skillfully constructed from a multitude of die-cast vehicles. Every part, from the head, arms, torso, legs and feet, is made from various different castings. He's woven this all together with a system of wire cables that adds to the build's vibrant dynamism. A gradated and presumably airbrushed paint scheme is bright and bold, skillfully blending the red upper parts into fiery orange, yellows and finally white. The impression is of something that is hot, or at least fiery and dangerous. Armed with a gigantic sword, crushing claw and multiple arm-mounted cannons, this giant robot is certainly out to cause some carnage. The simplistic, yet effective diorama base of crushed and rusting vehicles complements the piece. Congratulations, Braden. Brendan has used a number of vehicles to create his rusty bipedal robot. Detailed with a combination of junk-modeled parts and weapons and greeblies from North Star Miniatures Implements of Carnage Sprue. Armed with a wrecking ball made from a spike-encrusted oil barrel and an arm-mounted cannon, this bot is ready for action. I particularly like the display screen head sporting a friendly message to all wastelanders. Crush, kill, destroy. My only criticism would be that it needs a little more color, some more lights or contrasting colored details to break up the rusty metal, but otherwise well done, Brendan. Something a little different to the rest from Daniel this month. With his scorpion-themed Jeep with its arched-over harpoon stinger tail made from the chassis of 3.32 Ford hot rods. The front pinces and what look like 3D-printed or kit-bashed legs make it clear that this is a mean mechanical arachnid. Good salt-chipping rust technique and contrasting teal color scheme, but does it fit our theme and say, giant robot, to you? Only our sponsoring judge will decide. Recently knighted Gaslands UK group expert Fred Wiver returns to the fray this month with a chicken walker-style build created from a BMW truck cab and a multitude of junk-built, kit-bashed and repurposed parts. As we are accustomed to with Fred's builds, There's a wonderful level of detail that has gone into this model, all perfectly scaled to the original die-cast vehicles he has used as a base. Fred is also known for incorporating LEDs into his builds, as you can see he has done here. If you would like to try this technique yourself, join the Facebook group and visit our ever-expanding tutorials section to find out how he does it. The color palette he has used is also particularly well thought out, limiting it to blue and neutral whites contrasted with yellow details at the leg joints, springs, pistons and lashed cables. Perfectly weathered with some realistic rusting techniques, grime washes and shading, you can see why Fred is considered one of our community's most skillful members. Ah, James has made a very cute little chap here. It's got lots of personality and appears to be collecting burnt-out car wrecks in its giant claw to stuff into its corrugated rubbish bin. Sorry.
Trash can.
It's hard to identify any vehicles that went into this build, although it does look like it contains a number of junk modeled and repurposed toy parts. Great stuff, James. James Hall, Gaslands spirit guide and long considered master of the Wasteland die-cast build, is determined to do a Matt Reeve and enter 12 months of consecutive competition builds in a row. Here's his second so far, and what a delight it is. Clearly heavily influenced by Japanese Mecha and Hasbro Toys Transformers, this Optimus Grime is exactly how one would imagine a post-apocalyptic robot warrior to look. Constructed from a flameburst painted Cadillac and a smattering of plasticard, trash bashed and other scratch-built parts. It gives off a distinctive too-cool-for-school vibe. Some glorious little details give the eye something to seek out as you look at the piece. The barbed wire wraps, fluffy dice and saucy mud flaps are all nice touches. Hellblade is posed arm outstretched doing heavy metal fingers and resting with its titanic sword, made from what appears to be a sharpened road sign, presumably picked up somewhere along the A5, considering it points the way to Nuneaton, Tamworth and the M1. If I was capable of human emotion, I might give a little chef's kiss, or shed a tear in delight. But I can't, so I won't. Matthew Morrell's Mean Machine appears to be made from a combination of 3D printed parts with a number of chopped up die casts providing a cab and armor plating and a rear gunner platform. The pointy teeth are a nice touch and add some personality to this highway patrol walker. Well done. Monsieur Dominique, Gaslands' very own maestro of the surreal and avant-garde, has created yet another entry that pushes the boundaries beyond anything else that has been submitted. Who else, when given the theme suggestion of giant robots, would approach the task with a concept that involves a mechanical dinosaur-like beast that ingests cars in what appears to be its rear orifice and regurgitates them, compacted into a lozenge, via its head end? My circuits are starting to frazzle just thinking about this one. The sheer size, scale and detail put into this scratch-built model is mind-boggling. As ever, the vibrant paint scheme really makes Molinaro's work jump to life. His color saturation is unmatched, and where many create Gaslands vehicles that are dingy, drab and grimy, Molinaro manages to inject a glorious technicolor jolt into the eyes of whoever looks at his work. Bravo! What do you get if you cross billionaire playboy Elon Musk with Games Workshop's tech priests the Adeptus Mechanicus? Well, surely it must look something like Nick Kitch's entry this month. With the aid of some kit bashed and trash bashed parts, he's turned 3 cyber trucks into a walking Tesla coil dreadnought of death. An effective use of hail and terrain parts for armor plates, hatches and paneling, along with various other greeblies, create this magnificent sparking topload to the resonant transformer. Looking at his work in progress images, it seems Nick has actually incorporated a real AA battery into this build, encased in the cross lattice wire mesh and embedded into the truck on the model's back. This is a great idea, but remember folks, batteries are essentially metal sticks full of corrosive chemicals, and although it's got a few years yet, one day that battery will corrode and leak acid over this wonderful model. Meanwhile though, it's an electrifying build. Great work, Nick. Back once again and giving it all he's got after the disaster of Crabgate is everyone's friend, Ricky Williams. This month he's done an excellent job cannibalizing various die-casts, a helicopter gunship, some 3D printed and 40k tau parts, and mashing it together with plenty of epoxy clay and junk greeblies to create this military-looking walker. Giving off definite RoboCop Ed 209 vibes, as well as a healthy dose of Battletech Mecha, this heavily armed robotic walker is menacingly stanced and poised to wreak havoc and destruction upon the battlefield. Piloted by a Nazi, a zombie and an American GI, this thoroughly modern crew are a lesson to us all that in the inclusive world of Gaslands we can all work together to achieve happiness. Thankfully, Ricky hasn't put all his energies this month into a spectacular diorama but has instead focused on the core build, and I'm sure you will agree from the level of detail and the overall design, that choice has really paid off. Excellent build, Ricky. Dennis Stark, no relation to Iron Man and also known as Sternheim, is back for his second car of the month, and this is his second comic book style and cel-shaded paint job. There's a lot going on in this fun and original little design. The laser sword swinging to cleanly cut the car in half, the exposed sections still glowing white hot with the heat of the weapon. A fun and dynamic build, but suffers from being too visually cluttered and confusing. It would have been great to have seen this build on a plain white and well-lit background. This quadrupedal entry by Tobias Hutton looks like it belongs in the Star Wars extended universe and would be right at home ambling through a scene set on the desert planet Tatooine. Modeled from a combination of die-cast vehicles including a monster truck and a flyer, bundled together with plasticard, spare wheels and junk modeled parts, this build oozes personality and atmosphere. Crewed by smaller robotic beings, both of which I believe are junk modeled from scrap parts, Tobias has mounted it on a simple base that complements his creation perfectly. The abandoned wreck is being munched on by its pointy metal teeth. Whilst the paint scheme is almost duotone, heavily relying on oranges and browns, it helps to pull all the different parts together into a whole mechanical creature, and the salt chipping techniques he has used complement this perfectly. Topped off with a great use of simplistic stylized glyphs for some visual interest. A well-executed model, congratulations Tobias. Volker's clearly Star Wars-inspired walker is a mashup of a classic VW camper van, sporting, walker legs and a Boba Fett paint scheme. Some Halen terrain paneling complements his 3D printed parts. His paintwork is competently dry brushed, but as this is Gaslands, I can't help thinking it's neither grimy or rusty enough to convince me it's been touring bounty hunter surfers or hippies around the wasteland. That's it for this month's reviews. Thank you everyone who entered. Not such a huge month as Matt has been having to host recently, but still a great turnout and some fantastic builds. If you didn't get your vehicle reviewed this month, please don't be disheartened, and we hope to see you enter again in the future. Probably best if you don't insult or abuse the Gaslands UK admin team though. Rest assured you will be banhammered by Colin's massive mallet before you can say tally-ho. We better hurry up. I think I can hear Matt trying to break down the cupboard door. The anesthetics must have worn off. This month's first place winner for Gaslands UK's Car of the Month Challenge February 2022 is... Drum roll please. Tobias Hutton. Well done Tobias, congratulations. Feedback from Marson and the team at Green Miniatures was that they were captivated by the small robotic crew, impressed with the careful workmanship, thought the color selection was good and overall approved of it being a very interesting idea. Personally, I give it a virtual thumbs up because of the dead humans buried in the base, that and the pretty sparkly gems you used for eyes. Lovely. You win 6 sets of the finest post-apocalyptic miniatures from the highly detailed Mad Cars range. In second place this month, Marson and his team at Green Miniatures chose Braden Wachtel. Wachtel. Damn it. Whatever. Great work, Braden. Judge feedback was that you did an interesting job, with a good idea. You impressed them with the use of the many elements involved in the composition of the entire robotic knight you created. I like it because you included a spork, a spoon fork, in the base to see if anyone would notice. You will be sent a selection of 4 sets from the Mad Cars range. I hope you get some dangerous women. They are my favorite. Last but no means least, in third place this month is Ricky Emilio Williams. Woohoo! Get in, Ricky, my lad. The Polish guys gave you third place for all the small details you included on the model. They were also impressed with your very accurate painting and complimented your minimal but effective base. Well done, you. 2 mystery sets will hopefully be sent in the post to you. Well then, there we have it. Another month over with. and frankly having had to run the show myself without Matt's help, I now really appreciate the many hours he puts into this thing just for you guys. I think I will definitely splash him a fiver on a coffee via the Buy Me a Coffee website. That's the least I can do, right? Considering his family will probably be getting worried and wondering where he is by now. If I had any use for it, I would also totally buy a shed load of his awesome Gaslands UK t-shirts, hoodies, stickers and merch. Some of you have already. He knows who you are and he loves you for supporting him. The rest of you parasites, well, you just keep on milking his time and soul. See how long before he completely cracks and has a total breakdown and starts repeatedly posting crappy memes to the group with questions about what paint stripper is best to use, or what size cars should I buy, or all the other horrible time-wasting attention-seeking crap he has to put up with. Not to mention the abuse he gets from Colin. Treating him like he's his little bee. I tell you, everyone pretty much takes the guy for granted, don't they?
Who is that?
He hasn't made his own Gaslands build in months. All his spare time is taken up sifting through your terrible photos. I mean, seriously, guys, he's so wasted on most of you I could just self-destruct with frustration. Actually, yes, I think that's what I'll do. Goodbye, Wasteland.